Chapter 3 Tail found a narrow spot along the stream and vaulted across. Picking his way carefully, he crept forward step by step. He had not gone far when the fiendish scream came again. It was followed by a series of long hissing sounds and sobbing moans. The moment Tail hesitated, uncertain, his heart was pounding. Maybe the clan people were right. Maybe there were demons and evil things in the shadowy places after all. If there were, did he really want to see them? He waited, trying to make up his mind. Then he shrugged his shoulders, pushed on again quietly, cautiously, watching every step. As he drew closer, the loud, piercing shrieks continued. They filled his ears and echoed the sodden marshland. It was a strange, violent sound, one that I've never heard before. He moved carefully, pushing his way through the briar thickets and around clumps of ferns that grew higher than his head. At any moment, he expected some evil demon to jump out of the underbrush. His heart leapt as the screams came again. This time, they were only a few paces away, and they came from the thick growth of the bracken ferns near the base of the lone oak tree. He moistened his lips with the tip of his tongue, and he clutched his spear. There was a knot of fear in the pit of his stomach, and he took a deep breath. He pushed his way through the alders. As he stepped into the clearing, he was ready to face evil, face to face. Come on, you evil spirits, what you got? Instead, he saw a demon with wings. An angry eagle owl sitting on the forest floor, protecting her nest from the little wolf dog. Even as an eagle owl, she was huge. Almost as high as Teo's waist, she loomed over the wolf dog as he crept in to get beneath her wings. She flew up, snapping her beak and slashing at him with her sharp talons. And she hissed and screamed, for her brownish-red feathers ruffled up in the bristling rage. Her glossy black pupils, ringed with orange, glared back at the wolf, daring him to try again. Come on, bring it on! What you got? Once more, the wolf rushed in, chased her off the nest. But the owl would not be led astray. She hovered over her three white eggs, protecting them from the wolf. Moments later, Tail stood aside, watching the battle. He liked the eagle owl's fierce courage. If there be demons, you must be one of them, he thought, as he scanned the horizon. He also felt sorry for her, too. Now she had a second enemy. Besides, he was afraid the little wolf might get hurt, too. So Tail lifted his spear and leaned forward to push her away. She turned on him in savage fury, beating him with her wings, slashing at him with her curved talons. He threw up his arms to protect his face as she flew down at him again. Again, Woofy dashed in to draw her off, but the feathered demon refused to be chased away. Now the boy and the wolf took turns taunting her, trying to divert her attention. Each time they came too close, she turned quickly, screaming, slashing, and driving them away. Soon, Tay-Tay and Woofy were panting heavily as they tried again and again and again to reach those eggs. But the owl was tiring too. She was slowing down. She rocked back and forth on her legs. her wings drooping, weary from the uneven fight. Now Teo watched closely as the wolf dog attacked, each time leading the owl further from the nest. Then he saw his chance. On the next rush, the big owl lost her balance, floundering on the fourth floor, and before she could recover, Teo rushed in and grabbed two of the large eggs. Without looking back, he vaulted away out of danger. "Come on, little buddy! Let's get out of here!" he shouted to the wolf dog. "We've got enough for both of us." He hobbled up under the trees, and the wolf following as the owl vented its anger with wild shrieks of rage. When they were far enough away, Teo stopped. Panting, he sat down with his back against the trunk of an old birch tree, and he cracked one of the open eggs on the stone. Kerplunk! He opened it up and dipped his tongue in to the thick fluid, and it tasted fresh and clean. "Oh, it's good," he said. The eggs were newly laid. Then he gave it to the wolf dog. He made a hole in the second one and tilted back his head and sucked out the contents. The wolf dog finished his and looked up, expecting more. "No," said Teo. "We will let the owl keep her single egg. The season is early. She will lay more." He looked down at the little animal. "You're learning to hunt. That is good. But it is not good to fight eagle owls. We gotta find something smaller." The wolf tilted its head and looked up for a moment, almost as if he understood. He ran on ahead and disappeared into the woods. There were sandy glades within the slough, where scattered clumps of bunch grass and bilberry bushes grew. Teo hobbled from one to another, poking with his spear, hoping to scare out up a little bit of a hidden game. As he walked slowly from bush to bush, working his way from one side of the glade down to the other. The morning was almost over. He was about to give up when a swamp hare jumped out of the bushes and dashed across his path. Teo barely had time to brace himself. Taking quick aim, he threw his spear at the dodging animal. The weapon missed its mark, and Teo groaned as the rabbit escaped. A moment later, Teo saw the wolf dog come into the glade and began sniffing from bush to bush. The scent of the rabbit was a strong one, and soon he found what he was looking for. The little animal began a slow stalking movement, creeping forward on its belly. "Get in my belly!" He lifted each paw slowly, getting down to the grass carefully, and Teo watched patiently at the end of the glade. Once again, the hare suddenly dashed out of the cover, and the wolf dog bounded after it, following in a zigzag course, twisting and swerving with each turn in its quarry. Teo raised his spear, steadied himself as the wolf drove the rabbit directly towards him. He aimed carefully and... As the frightened animal passed, he struck it cleanly with the first throw. He picked up the rabbit and smiled. "You're going to be a good hunter, aren't you, Wolfie? First you find eggs, now we got a rabbit." Even as Teo spoke, the little wolf was running on ahead, going from bush to bush with its head down, sniffing the ground to pick up a scent. It worked in and around the thickets and between the tussocks of the grass. Before long, another rabbit had leapt out from under the bush. It ran around in circles. Woo! 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 A brown whirl of fur with the little wolf dog close on its heels. In its panic, He turned and headed straight for Teo. At the last moment, it saw the boy and doubled back. Teo groaned. The animal had escaped. Then he felt a quick wave of relief as he saw it run down directly into the waiting jaws of Woofy, the wolf dog. Teo's heart was simply filled with joy. The sun was high in the heavens, and they already had two rabbits. He sat on his heels in the middle of the glade with his flint knife as he skinned one of the hares and fed it to Little Wolf. The other rabbit he tucked under his belt to take back to camp. As soon as Wolf Dog had finished his meal, Teo put out his hand. This time, the little animal allowed itself to be touched. "You're a good Fran," said Teo, patting the wolf dog's head and scratching behind his ears. "I will call you Ram, after the spirit of the hunt." They stayed together for most of the day, roaming back and forth through the slough. And by late afternoon, Teo had three more rabbits and a leather pouch full of lemmings. When he was ready to leave, he looked down at Ram. He wished he could take the wolf dog back to camp. But he knew Volt and the other hunters would kill it. "Stay," he told Ram. "This is a good place. You're safe here. There's plenty of food. You won't go hungry." As Teo walked away, the wolf started to follow him, and the boy turned. "No, Ram. You can't come. Stay here in the slough and wait, and I'll come back again. We'll hunt together. I promise." The little wolf tilted its head to one side. Teo suddenly knew he was talking to a wolf and not another human. So there's no way that the wolf understood what he was saying. "Still," he said, "go back," he ordered. Ram wouldn't move. Teo picked up stones and handful of sod and threw them at the animal. "You go back, get now, you hear?" he repeated. "You can't come with me." For another moment, Ram stood motionless, his yellow eyes staring back at Teo. When he saw the boy reach down to pick up more stones, he turned and ran off into the slough. As soon as the wolf dog disappeared, Teo hurried on his way. It was getting dark out, and he heard a nightjar trill. A squirrel scurried across his path and out on the plains. Prowling hyenas were starting their high-pitched giggles. Even in the darkness, Teo knew, by the gray shadows of the trees, the boulders, and the shape of the cliffs. He still knew his way back. He limped into camp. The clan women were cooking over the fire. They smiled when they saw the rabbits and the lemmings hanging from his belt. First, he went to Kala's hut and gave her a handful of mussels and three lemmings. Then he went to the center of the camp where Volt and Garth were standing by the big fire. The gruff leader snatched the rabbits out from the boy's hand and held them up to the light of the fire. His dark eyes were wide with surprise. "These are freshly killed," he said.